You worked really hard to get where you are in your career, whether you are just starting out or further along, and you don't want the reason you end up resenting your career or where you're at because you took the wrong promotion. What do you mean took the wrong promotion? How can there be a wrong promotion? It's more money, better title. Tiff, you're crazy. Trust me, as someone who's been in the industry for over 5 years, I have seen software developers get pushed into areas, into promotions that maybe wasn't right for them. Okay, I'll listen to you. I'll hear you out. What do you got for me? Today, we are going to be talking about some tips that I always use before accepting a promotion. These are tips that I have learned from other mentors in the industry, and a promotion can mean so many different things. And before we get into some of the main tips when you are looking at a promotion and if it is right for you or not, I want to go through what some of the main career paths are for software engineers. And as a side note, I feel like I always need to say this, there always are exceptions to the rule. So these are just some roles that are very popular roles or career paths for software engineers. Also, of course, before we go any further, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career videos. It's free and it really supports me, and I love you all. Okay, let's get into it. Speaking of engineering leaders and getting promotions, I really wanted to share with you about a conference coming up. I am so excited about. For some of you, you might remember I was part of the Interact conference for their last one, and another one is coming up on October 25th. This is a completely free conference, it's virtual, and it's a great way to learn from other engineering leaders, network with others, and there is so much value that you can get from attending this conference. One of the things that stood out to me for this conference coming up is there are two tracks that you can focus on. Dev Interrupted, which is really focusing on listening to stories of failure and redemption. Panels that will be featuring some of the biggest names in engineering leadership. There's also a live recording of the Dev Interrupted podcast, which by the way is a great podcast for anyone looking to listen to a developer podcast, and some tips on how to grow in your career. Then the second path that you can choose from is Linear Beyond. So you can learn about the tactical practices, insights, and success stories that Linear B customers have used to transform their value delivery pipeline. Two really great paths that you can choose from, and I think both of them have a lot of value packed into them. Not to mention, some of the top companies will be there, including Slack, Stripe, Shopify, and so many more. One of my favorite things about this conference, although it is virtual, they have a live chat, so you can connect with speakers and other audience members. So if you see me there, make sure to say hi. And as far as networking goes, you get access to the Dev Interrupted Discord channel. This Discord channel is filled with other engineering leaders that you can bounce ideas off of, learn from, and it's a great way to build your virtual community. I have linked the Interact conference down below. Make sure to sign up today. As I mentioned, it's completely free. I will be there, so I'll see you soon. And here is some more information about it. It is an all-day event, and yes, it will be recorded, but make sure not to miss the real thing, as there will be so much opportunities for networking and virtually meeting other people. Also, don't forget to tell your colleagues and your friends, this event is for everyone. It's completely free, so make sure to register. Okay, let's get back into promotions. One of the most popular career paths for software engineers is project management. But what exactly is a product manager? A product manager wears many different hats, and the role can vary company to company. But on average, the product management role consists of being responsible for the development of products for an organization. Product managers really own the product strategy and specify its functional requirements and manage feature releases. Feature releases, I think, is a huge role of product managers, and it's also a really great way that software engineers can grow into that role, coming from the understanding of how long features will take to build, what complexity is required, all of that you can bring with a software engineering background. Another very popular career path that software engineers go down is solutions architect. This is actually kind of a fun fact. The career path I initially thought I was going down, I've kind of pivoted, which I think is important to do, but it's still a very popular career path for software engineers. Solutions architects are responsible for creating the overall vision and strategy when it comes to a specific solution for a business problem. Now, for example, when I was working in consulting as a software engineer, there was a lot of solution architects needed because we were working with different clients who had different problems, and solution architects would come in and find the best way to solve those problems. And also in the solutions architect role, it can really vary on how much coding is done. When I was speaking to solution architects, when I was interested in this career path, one thing that stood out to me though is there isn't on average, that much coding. Of course, you're going to go from software engineering into a different role. Many of these roles won't be to the same degree coding, but there is still some coding required in solutions architect roles. Now, that's on average. Of course, some solution architects don't code anymore, and one of them really put it well for me, which is you code as much as you want to, meaning you can get your hands in there as much as you want to. Another very popular career path that software engineers, it's actually a newer one. When I say newer, the role's been around for a while, but something that more software engineers are going towards is developer advocacy. Developer advocates have been around for a long time, but have really recently become more popular and in demand. And I think that is because as we continue to move everything over to the digital world, the need for onboarding developers, creating content around products is becoming more and more essential. Companies are realizing that they need people to do developer advocacy-like work. Now, what does a developer advocate do? And that can really vary as well based on company to company. Developer advocates though wear different hats when it comes to public speaking, creating coding tutorials, documentation, blog posts, creating this community online, and also to teaching developers how to use their product. And I think a really important part of developer advocacy is being able to do this in a very authentic and genuine way. So you don't want to come across as though you're part of the sales team where you're like, hey, this is a great product, but rather really building that authentic community. The first thing you really need to ask yourself is, why do you want this promotion? And this can be for a ton of different reasons, whether it be from the money, the title, maybe you just feel like you're stagnant and you want to change. This is really important to ask the why you want this promotion, because it will really depict if this promotion is right for you. For example, if it is for more of a money aspect, you want a higher salary, a bigger bonus, whatever the case may be, you might be asking yourself, are you enjoying what you are actually doing, but just not getting paid enough for it? If that is the case, a promotion might not be your best next step. Maybe talking to your manager about the situation, about how you feel for a number of reasons why you need a higher salary, or if that doesn't work, then maybe start looking at other places as well. If it is because you're actually interested in what the role entails that you will be doing in the promotion, that's a different story then. That means that you are actually ready for this promotion, you are looking forward to it, and you also understand that with a promotion, it also means a change in what you're actually doing on a day-to-day. The next question that is really important to ask is, will you be managing people? And this is a question I always say it's really important to ask, because a lot of times when you get the next promotion or get that manager title, director title, whatever the case may be, you need to really take a step back and see, is this something you want as far as managing people? And sometimes it's not necessarily managing people, sometimes it's managing processes. And I think there needs to be more clarity, because when you're coming from a software engineering or a software developer role into a management position, it's easy to say, oh, managing people will be great, this will be easy. But managing people is a whole other world in itself, comes with a lot of highs and a lot of lows and a lot of new challenges. So before you accept a promotion, you really need to take a step back and also understand, is managing people or managing processes something that you're interested in? And if so, why? Going back to the first point, why is so important? Because that will really depict if this promotion is right for you. And on the note of managing people, if you are not managing or just managing a few people, you will need to understand or undercover where your time will be spent. Because if you're not managing people or processes, what are you going to be doing? And these are totally fine conversations, totally normal conversations to have with your manager or people who are going through the promotion process with you. Okay, so I'm not going to be managing people. What will I be doing with my time? How will it be different than what I am currently doing? This will also give you further insight as to what the promotion and the next step in your career will look like, and if it is a good fit for you or not. For example, ask about the types of decisions you'll be involved in, what meetings you'll attend, if you'll be involved in the budget or decisions when it comes to the actual product, building features, whatever the case may be, but what does this role really look like? Because I can guarantee if you are seeing someone do this role, it is very different from what you are viewing from the outside versus when you're actually doing it. And that brings me to my next point, is ask and get clarity of what a typical day would look like. And this is super easy to do, whether it's through someone who is already in that role, or if no one's in that role, if you're at a smaller company, speaking to others about what their expectations are for you in that promotion. And I think this is really important, and it kind of touches on the next point I'm going to make, so I'll kind of combine them into one, which is, how technical will this role be? I think one of the things that as software engineers, we get really nervous about, or many of us do, is losing our technical skills, and will we be continuing to grow them and build upon them? Or as we grow in our career, is that aspect going to be lost? For me, I know that's something that I really struggled with for a long time growing in my career, especially in the direction I'm growing my career with developer advocacy, is will my technical skills be lost? And the answer is absolutely not, for myself anyways, but in the promotion you will take or are considering taking, you really need to know how much technical aspects will be included in this, and are you okay with that? Because it's one thing to say, yeah, I'm fine with it, I'll build projects on the side, but do you really have the time to do that? Be very honest and candid with yourself. Have a very hard conversation with yourself, because if you accept a promotion and there's very little technical aspects involved, you might find yourself really resenting it or finding disdain for it. And the reality is, as you grow in your career, unfortunately, it doesn't have to be this way, but a lot of times software engineers get pushed into roles that are not as technical. And I think that's because people are still figuring out how to grow in different areas when it comes to software engineers. For example, I think a very common, as we spoke about earlier, career path for software engineers is to move into product management. And you can get into product management without any software engineering skills or background, but it's a very common path for software engineers that I see. And of course, with product management, if you come from a software engineering background, the skills and knowledge you have will really set you apart. So there is something to say for that, but it's not needed, and you will be using you'll still be using your knowledge, but you won't be, for example, coding on a day-to-day basis. So you really need to step back and say, are you okay with that? Because I also know some amazing software engineers who were like, no, managing people, managing processes, that's not what I wanna do. I wanna code, for the rest of my life, you know, 9-to-5 coding, and grow that way, grow into a senior engineer, grow into a dev team lead, but stay on the engineering path. Okay, let's talk a little bit about performance. And this is something that is a huge shift for going from a solo software engineering job where you are kind of working for the most part independently. Of course, you are collaborating with different teams, designers, product managers, but for the most part, there is chunks in your day that you are focused on by yourself, your coding. Whereas when you get promoted and you continue to grow your career, how will your performance be measured? Because it will look a lot different from when you were solo coding, people reviewing your PRs, to now as more of a managerial or a director level, being evaluated based on your team's output. Okay, I hope that gave you some really good insight as to different things you should look for before accepting a promotion, because it can seem all great at first, especially new title, maybe new salary, new role. It sounds really great, but at the end of the day, you need to take a step back and really make sure that this aligns with your career and your vision for it. Of course, I think it's important to not have focus too narrow-minded, that you don't see opportunities that you least expected come up. Of course, that's important, but you don't want to be forced or pushed into a promotion just because it seems like the next step. A lot of software engineers don't want to go into a manager role or want to go into a director role. They want to stay coding, and there are tons of different career paths that you can stay coding as well and grow that way. But before you accept that promotion, you really need to know what the day-to-day looks like, what is involved, how are you going to be evaluated? Speaking of leadership roles, make sure to join me at the Interact conference. I linked it down below. It's completely free, virtual, and it's a great way to network with other software engineering leaders or leaders in the tech industry.